irresponsible without your money, I know. Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Couldn't see us, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around, just like the hell in the clock. Are you irresponsible without your money, I know. Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hands on the clock. Come like a bat out of hell, I dare you to cross like a reverend. And my energy paralyzed, I'm like I'm finger 11. Take a second, I'm finna send it like a parent a message. You the best, if it ain't me, then you need you a confession. You a mess, you ain't scary to me. Heard you was a leader, but that ain't apparent to me. Thoughts on you, a cheater, run down, I'm airing the scene. I feel just like Vegeta Prince and I'm an heir to the seat. I mean, for real. Touch the driver's saw so I don't even grab the wheel. That's a lot on my chest, but it don't mean the man is stealing. Man, I'm walking with some money, man, I mean a couple mil. Ew, think you need a mail. You ain't even eating while I'm feasting in the field. That's why I'm always cheesing, cause I feel like Uncle Phil. And all this losers think they're fresh, but they ain't half the man as well. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around, just like the hell in the clock. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around, just like the hell in the clock. July the hands of the clock, I go back to bat when I'm doing numbers. All the mad that I'm driving the bus, so they threw me under. Heard they mad, they don't wanna bust, so they boo each other. Think that they're the winning team, go losing, then they choose another. And that's okay, cause I'm competing with me, not you. I live with blessings like I can't stop sneezing, not you.
I hate to break a boy, me and myself top two. I blow away the competition like a bowl of hot soup.
And there's no catch, I go and get the bag and I'm not bringing it back. I'm like a down QB, I put the pain in the past. And if you ever had a problem, promise I didn't ask. So it's 444 in the karma dash. I shake a pick, told them all, you ain't first, you last. Little boy, that's facts, I'ma grow that cash to my money.
Today, from SoFi Stadium in Inglewood, California, it's the NFC Divisional Round Playoffs on EA Sports.
We are pleased, as always, to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. Ahead, we'll decide the second entrant to next week's NFC title game, as we've got a great one in store. Between the Philadelphia Eagles, and able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. And the Los Angeles Rams. They'll come out throwing here on first down. They'll get this complete to Cooper Kupp. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. So flag for the contact, pass interference.
And I know that you're going to look at me and roll your eyes, and rightfully so, because you know what I'm going to say. Doesn't the defender have a right to the football as well?
No, I don't like defenders.
That's because you spend too much time with me. Okay, I'll side with you on this one. It's the correct call.
That's over 40 yards of movement with those last two plays. Our game not even 2 minutes old, but a quick red zone opportunity. They've got a first and 10 from the and he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown Rams. A 10-yard touchdown run. And the Rams are going to take a first quarter lead. So they take the opening kickoff and drive it all the way down the field.
And that's the last thing you want defensively. On the road, in the playoffs, and now you're down a touchdown right away.
It's up, it's good, and the Rams take a 7-0 lead.
Is good.
So that drive, 4 plays. And it was Cam Akers who capped it off with a touchdown. And a short kick taken at about the 16. Lane opens here. He's past the 30.
The Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 34-yard line.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Operating from the gun. Green. He's got his target. It's the tight end, Tyler Higbee. That catch good for only a couple. Line of scrimmage, the 36 on second and 8.
On the pickup. It's second and 8.
From the gun, Green. He's going to drop this down to Sanders. It'll be a gain of 6, and that'll bring up a third down.
We'll see what kind of mindset they have here offensively after giving up the touchdown on the opening drive.
And based on our time with them, you know, prior to this game, I feel like they've got a good mindset going in. In fact, the discussion that we had with the coaching staff was, you know, we may give up some points in this game, so offense has to be ready each and every time to either equal or try and get us ahead and try and keep us ahead. This is their chance to respond to that first touchdown given up.
Holding offense.
Now that's one they hate. The ball's got to come all the way back.
So that's an explosive play, a really explosive play that gets wiped out, and they have to start over after the penalty.
To throw is Green on third down. And the throw there going to be incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
This is brought in at the 21. A 40-yard punt, give him 3 on the return. And the Rams will go on offense here for the first and 10. They'll begin on the ground with Akers. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive. First down. Well, they're making a real first quarter statement with a run game, no doubt.
For those who remember old school football, running it, establishing things, seeing backs find holes, get through them, they got to like what they're seeing from this unit so far. Right now, they've decided to, as you said, establish the run game, and they've been successful doing it.
The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. Taken in. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, but it's good for a first down as well.
At the 48-yard line.
On the ground, it's Akers. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. That's a gain of 13, first down Rams.
One thing's for sure, this defense has to figure out how to stop the ground game. He's eating him up here in the first quarter.
It looks like they have to go to different forces, aren't they? The conventional things aren't working too well. So I remember a coach of mine saying way back when a back's having a great game, you've got to get the ball out of his hands. See how far he can run without the ball. And what he meant was takeaways, not get loose, because maybe you can't just stop him and just run.
Now that'll be tipped and intercepted. Thing he said as we were walking off the field, want to play mistake-free football. Well, that just went out the window there with a pick.
And do you remember what you said to me when we were walking up to the booth after he said that? You're like, oh, fatal last words. Every time we hear that, things tend to fall apart a little bit, and that's what we saw there. Didn't get enough on that throw, and it turned into an interception.
3 yards the gain there, 2nd down.
At the 41-yard line, a 3-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 7.
First carry for the Boise State Bronco, Alexander Madison. Still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to 3rd down.
A gain of 4, and it's 3rd down.
And they'll let their fullback try and push the pile. And he's got enough for the first across midfield to the 48. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
A gain of 7. And an Eagle first down.
After 1-7-0 on EA Sports.
With the score, Rams 7, Eagles nothing.
Now Green on 1st and 10. And this will be incomplete.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
And the Rams defense gets to him again behind the line of scrimmage.
This defense is really flown around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense got to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
Left side here to Sanders. And he gets this only to the 44-yard line. Not near
enough to keep the drive alive. They do get 7 out of that, but not enough to prevent a fourth down.
How about that strategy there, Brandon? Third down, they just said, we've got faith in our tackles. We'll give you the short stuff, and just decided to protect the sticks. So every time I hear fans telling me tackling's not a part of the game anymore, plays like that, I can clip and save and show them you have to tackle well if you want to be a good defense.
Set to go again. Here's Cam Akers in the L.A. offense. And he's well on his way to a 100-yard game. He's already more than halfway there. We're only in the second quarter.
And what I've always loved about running backs is they'll tell you, I had no idea how many yards I had.
Right.
Those guys have an innate sense of where they are in a ball game and how many yards they've accumulated, because you know they're always working towards 100.
He's been working well towards 100 here. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 15. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
First and 10 at the 15-yard line.
Here's Akers. And that closed up quickly there as he gets it up only to about the 17. And credit the tackle to Derek Barnett. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9.
Well, partner, I don't think it's any secret that any running back wants to be able to see a hole open so that he can gallop through it. But in this case, he had to slow down. There was really no hole there. And he took a big hit in order to get that 1 yard.
Nothing on the screen that time. Now it's third down. So nothing there on the screen that time.
That means all that great acting they tried on offense went for naught, didn't it? Because you have to try and influence them. Make them think that you're doing something else. Make them think that they can get to the passer by letting them by and then setting up the screen and getting downfield. Didn't happen at all. Give a lot of credit to the defense for not tumbling to that one. So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They've had it twice. They punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all. And let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice. So they're furiously going over things on the sidelines. What do we need to do to pick up a first down and change our momentum?
And he'll try the jet sweep here. And he'll fight his way forward to about the 48-yard line. It's Logan Wilson there to bring him down.
On the tackle. It's a pickup of 3. Brings up second and 7.
Off the play fake. Green. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
And partner, to me, that one was all about timing. If he's there too early, it's going to be a pass interference call. If he's too late, it's a completed pass. He was Johnny on the spot on that one.
And here's Green to throw on third down. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he is going to have an Eagles first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. It's an Eagles first down on a gain of 11. Operating from the gun, Green, and quickly finding Rager. And the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves him with 2 to go on second down. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion.
At the Rams' 33-yard line.
We remind you, as we've done all year, that coming up at halftime, we will visit with Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll let you know what's going on here. A very eventful divisional round weekend. After the incompletion, here now, 3rd and 2. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And he's got his man in stride, complete. Of course, he's coming off that monster game with their wild card victory, but that's his first catch here in the divisional round.
First down, Philadelphia.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Open man, Higbee, the tight end.
Complete.
A gain of 6 there on first. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Open man is Higbee, the tight end. And this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11. Call that a loss of a yard, and things get a little more difficult here. Third and five. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Green from the gun on third down. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12.
And that was a heck of a play there on the outside.
Partner, sometimes I think on a play like this as a corner, you've got to think to yourself, all I got to do is slow him down so others can come over and support. But in this case, he said, forget that. I've got this. Sorry you had to make the run for nothing, fellas.
Makes the score Rams 7.
So a late three there, and that'll help as they head into the break.
Talk about situational football and something they've worked on since the OTAs and minicamps the previous summer. They take care of the ball, get 3 points, knowing they're going to get the ball to start the second half. That's the old two-for-one special to finish things off.
So we've come upon halftime here. You want the third quarter already? No problem. Let's do it.
Eagles 3.
A trip to the NFC title game hanging in the balance. Second half action back underway. Takes this about 5 yards deep, and he will not bring it out. It's a touchback. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And with the way this offense has played thus far, to be frank, they got to feel pretty grateful to be in the ball game.
I would agree with you totally, because they've done all nothing offensively in this game, yet they still find themselves in a position.
Look at this, middle of the field, a breakaway. Touchdown, Philadelphia.
Number 13.
A big play there. 75 yards. And the Eagles have taken the lead. They talked about stringing together some explosive plays here in the playoffs. That was a pretty explosive play.
It certainly was. And if you're going to win on the road, it certainly helps to have big playability in your hip pocket, doesn't it?
Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
They're over the 23-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. They'll look to throw now on first down. Going up top for Kupp. It's caught inside the 25. And he finally goes down, but not before reaching the 21.
It's your first drive of the second half. You're down on the scoreboard. Maybe you just say to yourself, let's take a shot, see if we can shake them up. And boy, they hit that one.
They'll run on first down with Akers. They'll get it inside the red zone, but only for a couple down to the 19.
Taken down.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description, because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
They'll look to run with Akers. And he's going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown. Cam Akers, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Rams are going to jump back in front.
Jason Sanders.
He's given him a little jolt, just gave him the lead there, but two TDs now in the game.
And that jolt puts them in the lead. What a terrific job by him. He is carrying the ball and simply saying, I want to win.
And now he's hoping his defense has that mentality as they try to hang on to that lead. And this carries into the end zone. And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return.
25-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. But I believe it was covered by an Eagle. It was. And Philadelphia is going to hold on to the football.
The fumble on first down. Now here's second down.
From the gun, Green. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. He was in search of his tight end, Tyler Higbee. And it's third down. Operating from the gun, Green. That's complete to his tight end, Higbee. And they're going to get him down well short of the first as he can only get this to the 30. They'll get 11, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
One of the money routes for any offense, the drag route. So tough to defend because the receiver can stop at any point and make himself available to the quarterback and get a completion. I love the communication we saw there. All the defenders pointing out the receiver, where he was going, and then able to rally to the ball after the catch and stop him short of a first down.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33.
Set to go again. Here's Cam Akers in the LA offense.
He is knocking on the door for 100 yards in this ball game.
And it's so important. It doesn't seem like it's that big of a deal. Just short of it, a little bit over. A little bit over feels better to everyone. Offensive line, running back, team totals, just something magical about breaking that barrier.
He's right there on the doorstep now.
4 yards the pickup, first down.
First and 10 at the 45-yard line.
On play action, they'll throw. Gets this into the hands of N'Keal Harry. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 35. It's a Rams first down on a pickup of 10.
First and 10 at the 45-yard line.
They'll run this with Akers.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
Left side, a completion to his tight end. And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 22-yard line.
Nice job there of utilizing his big target. He didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius, understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball, and puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
And it appears we've got a member of the Rams shaking up on that last play. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break.
After the pickup of 5, here's second and 5.
Now this one to his running back out of the backfield. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. That gain of 15 gets him on the doorstep, first and goal.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eye.
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Rams add on to their lead. That seemed pretty ideal there for the offense, Charles. You take a little bit of time off the clock here in the third quarter, decent length drive, and you pad your lead as well at the end of it.
And what it does is let you feel like you're in control of this game, even more so than a 2-touchdown lead, right? Because you've taken that time off, as you noted, which means they couldn't get you off the field. You ran your playbook the way you wanted to, and you gave your defense some rest. What a big-time drive in that situation.
Now a crease here as he's past the 30. And he will be taken down here on the return on what will wind up being the final play of this third quarter. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And this could be the defining moment of their season, all hyperbole aside. You're trailing here in the fourth quarter, the divisional round. And they need to come up with something as they get this drive started. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion.
And 2 at the 42-yard line.
Drain now to throw on second down. That'll be caught. Rager with it. And he'll get it out to midfield. Let's say, yeah, he'll spot it right at midfield at the 50.
An 8-yard pickup and an Eagles first down.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Quick hitter here, it's complete. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two.
Second and two at the Rams 42 yard line.
From the gun, Green gets this into the hands of the tight end, Higbee. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle is going to be made at the Rams' 24-yard line.
Well, every drive from here out is definitely crucial and critical. They know that they need to get at least three here to get it back to a one-score game. I can't imagine that in their huddle that they're thinking at all about getting a field goal. They want to get into the end zone and then try to get the ball back again.
And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays.
First down, Philadelphia.
On first and 10, it's Sanders. And here he'll get it down to the 7. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
A gain of 4. It's now second and 6.
They'll go again with Sanders. And a little bit of space there. Takes it inside the 5 to the 3. Give him 4 on the carry, and it'll make this a 3rd and about 2. So a decent deficit at this stage in the second half. 4-down territory?
No doubt about it. There's not a chance that he hasn't looked ahead and said, okay, if we gain yardage on this play, this is what we'll do going forward. If we lose yardage, this is the play call that I'll have ready. They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs. Able to knock that one away on 3rd down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected 4th down here.
The score, Rams 21.
All right, so they needed 2 scores to get back in the game. The field goal there, maybe not exactly what they wanted, but the necessary first step.
There's still time remaining, and there's enough time to get it done. They've got to get at the least a 3 and out here to get the ball back. Preferably a takeaway.
Set to go again. Here's Cam Akers in the LA offense. He's already hit pay dirt twice. He's up over 100 yards. He is feeling good.
And he's just zipping along today. Everything coming together for him. It's that type of a day that you see a back just kind of have a grin on his face every time his number is called. Because he doesn't feel like there's going to be any lost yardage plays. Nothing but big time positive runs.
Making the sideline grin as well. 2nd and 11. Decision, a good one. Picking up the first, getting 14 yards on the scramble. Well, there you go. Save your best scramble of the day for a big-time situation in the 4th quarter. Picking up the first.
You don't want to use it up early, right? You want to make sure you save it for that exact moment, that key time. And that's what he did, although you and I both know it wasn't planned that way. But what a nice job using his eyes, scanning the field, and realizing when it was time to exit the pocket and go.
A 14-yard pickup. That's 14 yards on 2 straight plays. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up 1st and 10. So it's Rams football here as we get your reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves them with 2 to go on 2nd down. So fresh out of the 2-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. So they come up on 2nd down, and they can get another run like we just saw. We'll likely put an end to this thing. They'll go again here with Akers, and he'll take this one down to about the 40. Whistles now and a timeout. So defensively, they burn it here with 1:51 left. They'll try and run through this with Akers. And he will have a 1st down as they get him to the ground at the 37. The Eagles will take their 3rd and final timeout. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the 1st down. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he'll be taken down at the 34.
He's tackled at the 30.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down.
Brings up 2nd and 7.
Now a run with Akers. A gain of three last play. This time they double it and pick up six.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
On third down, here's a run by Akers. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. It'll go as a gain of 12, and that should just about wrap this one up.
I'm not sure how much more evidence they need, partner, than to understand that if they don't start to slow him down, it's going to be a long afternoon here at the stadium because he is just shredding them at this point. And let's face it, coming into the game, they knew he would be the focal point of their attack. This is going to take an 11-man unit on the defensive side to start making plays.
Here's a run with Akers on second down. And still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down.
Tackle made at the 9-yard line. It's a gain of four. Brings up third and three.
On third down, Akers. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. The Rams are on to next week as we say so long, everybody. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more,
game over, time's up. Play my cards, dumb, my hand ain't really no time for luck. Either you got it, you don't. Lie to yourself if you won't. I put my team on my back. Did what I could, what I had. Now I'll be all in my bag. Copy and paste with the swag. Bet you can't do it like me. All my winnings on repeat.